Yes, good morning. Today we are going to discuss the question answers of the Happy Prince. So why do the courtiers call the prince the Happy Prince? Is he really happy? And what does he see all around him? Am I audible, children? Am I audible here? Am I audible, Nivedita? Okay. Yes, Tanvi, thank you. So why do the courtiers call the prince Happy Prince? Yes, Dharya.
The courtiers call the prince the Happy Prince because that he was a very happy and a joyful person. So he was worried about in his palace. And but after this, he had to go to the king's court as he was nailed to a statue. And he saw the poverty and sadness of sorrow and poverty.
Okay. So the first part was like, why do the courtiers call the prince the Happy Prince? The reason is like when he was alive, he lived in palace, and palace is a place where all luxuries and comforts are there. So the one who lives in palace doesn't need to witness or see or experience any sorrow or unhappiness or any unpleasantness. So he never ever happened to be sorrowful in his life. So he always used to be happy. So the courtiers used to call him as being a happy prince. So is he really happy? So he doesn't remain happy after death, because after death, his statue is put up at the center of the city. And from there, he could see the sorrows. He could see all the whole city with many people who lived a very miserable and poverty-stricken life. So that drained him of all his happiness and he became sad. So what does he see all around him? So what does he see all around him? Yes. Okay. So what did he see around him? He finds misery, poverty, unpleasantness, hunger all around him. Right? So that made him become all the more miserable. And if this question comes in the form of a long question, then here in this part, you can explain the all stories, the story of the Semestress, the story of that. The story of the story writer. And one more. Match girl, the girl who sold matchsticks. So then you can tell all the stories, and the gist of all the stories is that there was hunger, poverty, and misery prevailing all around. And that made him very unhappy, and he did not mind shedding his own or parting with his own rubies, sapphires, or even gold from his body. So why does the Happy Prince send a ruby for this mistress? Yes. You can come here.
Because her child has a high fever and was very ill, and her mother has nothing but river water. So the Happy Prince sent the ruby to help him.
Okay. Well done. What's your name?
Ishan.
Ishan. So Ishan gave good answer. So the Happy Prince sent a ruby for this mistress to help her to help her to get rid of her poverty, misery, or hunger. Actually, she was stitching a satin gown for the queen's maid, which she would be wearing during a party. This mistress herself was leading a very miserable life. Her own son was sick. He had high fever and wanting oranges. But she was so poor that she could not even fulfill his that much of demand. So she, being very tired, fell asleep, but the sun kept on tossing about the bed. So that made the happy prince become unhappy, and he sent a ruby to help her out so that her son would recover and would feel happy with whatever he wanted. Right? What does the swallow do in the mistress's house? So what does the swallow do in the mistress's house? Okay, here online students can also speak. Dhavni will speak. Dhavni, unmute yourself. Dhavni, raise hand. Okay, Jia or Janvi from here.
Ma'am,
Yes.
And he laid the ruby on the table of the seamstress and fanned the boy's forehead with her fingers.
Okay.
And fanned the forehead with his fingers.
Okay, now Tanveer will speak.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble, and then he flew gently around the bed, with his wings he provided warmth to the boy's forehead.
Okay, well done. Yes. Yes.
The swallow took the ruby from the prince and gave it to the poor mistress to fulfill her needs. And then when she looked at her son, that he was suffering from the cold, and she fanned the boy as by feeling cold, he soon slept.
Okay, well done. We like your giggling in between.
The swallow do in the seamstress. When he saw the boy suffering from cold, the swallow started fanning the boy with his wings. And the boy goes in deep sleep with the cold and feels now better. And he gave the ruby to the seamstress so that she could buy some medicines and food to eat for the boy.
So it was a complete explanation of the answer. But in nutshell, if you say, like, what did swallow do in that house? He kept the ruby. Yes, he kept the ruby on the table. So what? Yes. For whom does the prince send the sapphires? Yes, Manavi, stand up and speak. For whom does the prince send the sapphires and why?
The prince sent the sapphires for the young man in the garret who was trying to finish his story. It was too cold to write anymore, and he was fatigued of thinking. There was no fire in the grate. So the prince sent him the sapphires, and he was overjoyed by seeing them.
Well done, Manavit. So for whom does he send the sapphires? He sends the sapphire for the story writer or the playwright. He sends the sapphire for the playwright. The one who had been... who had to write a play for the theater, but was not able to do because of hunger and cold. The happy prince sent him the sapphire so that he could get some money out of it and could buy the fuel for his grate and could buy some food for his stomach. So this way he tried to help him out. For whom does the prince send the sapphires? Okay, one sapphire he sent to the playwright, and the other sapphire he sent to the match girl. That girl, the one who was very poor and would earn by selling the matchsticks. But that day her matchsticks fell in a gutter and was not able to earn anything. And she was afraid of going home because her father would beat her in case she would go empty handed. Moreover, it was very cold. It was raining. So the happy prince sent the sapphire to help that girl out so that she would be welcomed at home. Right? So why does this fellow see? What does this fellow see when it flies over the city? So what does this fellow see? Ishan? Yes. Others can also raise hand from online class.
The swallow see the rich decorating their houses while the beggars were staying at their gates. The swallow flew into the dark streets and saw the faces of starving children. He saw two children trying to keep themselves warm under the bridge.
It's very good. Very well done, Ishan. Okay, now who else will speak the same answer from online class? Yes, besides Dia, Janvi, and Tanveen, who else wants to give answer? Let me ask anyone. Arshdeep Kaur, unmute yourself. Arshdeep Kaur.
Yes, ma'am.
Speak the answer number 4.
So, when the swallow flies over the city, he saw many upset people, like the children who were hungry and were suffered from coldness of the weather.
Okay, the swallow saw hunger, misery, and poverty when it flies over the city. It saw the city full of hunger, starvation, hunger, misery, or poverty. Then you have to explain this all, like what kind of hunger, who was hungry, who were poverty stricken. Explain all that from the text, right? So next question is, why did this swallow not leave the prince and go to Egypt? Yes, Lavanya, come here and give answer. Why did the swallow not leave the prince and go to Egypt?
Swallow does not want to leave the prince and go to Egypt because she loved him. He loved him very much, and he wanted to support and help him to see what is happening there in the city.
Yes, well done, Lavanya. Anything else? Yes. Hrithi, come here. Why did
Stella
want to leave the prince?
As the prince was also blind, so he don't have eyes and can't see the world, his city. So the swallow was there to tell him about the city, and also she loved him for his honesty and kindness.
Yeah, that's okay. So the point is, like, why didn't swallow want to leave the prince? So the swallow doesn't want to leave the prince because he had seen that the prince had given everything for the well-being of the people of the city. He had given up everything. He had sacrificed his all for the good of others. He had learned the lesson of sacrifice from him. So he got to realize that he also can sacrifice his life for the good of the happy prince, the one who had given up everything for the good of others. Okay, main thing is this. He learned to sacrifice from the happy prince. If the happy prince could sacrifice his happiness, his all, then why couldn't he? So he also decided to stay back and help the happy prince, the one who was an epitome of sacrifice, kindness, and generosity. Got it? You can call Swallow as he also, because earlier people used to describe the birds or animals with it, but it's not so. You can describe animals and birds can, as with he or she also. So that's not considered wrong. Okay. So if you use it, that would also be correct. If you use he or she, then also the birds or animals are considered okay. So the swallow did not leave the prince because it had learned to sacrifice one's comforts, luxuries for the sake of others from the prince itself. If the prince could sacrifice his all for the good of others, then the swallow was also ready to do the same. Okay, it did not even mind sacrificing its own life for the happy prince, the one who had lost his eyes and even the gold for the good of others. Okay, what are the precious things mentioned in the story and why are they precious? So what are the precious things mentioned in the story? Who will give answer now? Harshita will give answer. What are the precious things in the story? Come here.
The two precious things in the story were the angel and the leaden heart of the king, because they both sacrificed their life for the sake of other.
One you are saying the leaden heart, another you are saying?
Swallow.
It's okay. She says that swallow and the leaden heart are the two most precious things in the story. And there is something right, okay? Not wrong. We'll discuss your point. Very good. How many of you say like sapphire, ruby are the precious things in the story? They are not precious things.
Yeah.
They are or not?
They are for the fanfare.
Yeah. So, okay, first of all, let us discuss that the precious... Literally, the precious things in the story are the sapphires and ruby. Sapphires, ruby, gold, the golden leaves. Right? So, yeah. Literally, frankly speaking, literally, the precious things in the story are the sapphires, the ruby, and gold leaves. Because they are precious because they can be used to help somebody out. They can fill somebody's empty stomach. They can provide somebody a shelter. They can give somebody the clothes. So yes, they are of course the precious things, but yes, the most precious things in the story are the leaden heart and the swallow. Should we say dead swallow or swallow? Why not the real swallow? So the most precious things in the story are the leaden heart of the happy prince and the swallow itself. Because while they were alive, the leaden heart, the heart of the prince made the happy prince feel the pain of the poor and downtrodden. Okay? It was the heart which made the happy prince feel the pain of others. And because of that pain, he was able to help them out with those precious things. Had he not been that hearty fellow, had he not been that kind and generous person, he would not have used sapphires and ruby and gold to help them out. They would have been there lying lifeless. Okay, those precious things could be of some use because of the hearty heart, because of the kind heart, which was no doubt a leaden heart. And secondly, the swallow is of course a very precious bird, even when it was alive. When it was alive, it was able to help the happy prince. He was able to help the happy prince, or it was able to fulfill the desire of the happy prince to help the poor and downtrodden. Got it? So number one, talk about the precious things which are literally precious, but children, gold and all in themselves, they are useless. If you keep gold here, if you keep gold in your bank lockers, diamonds there, they are useless. They won't serve any purpose. Unless and until you take them out and adorn yourself, what purpose are they doing? Nothing. But yes, when they are there to help somebody, or when they can fulfill somebody's empty stomach, can give somebody shelter, or can make somebody happy, then only they become precious. Okay? But anyone's heart, any person who has a kind and generous heart, that is more precious than anything else. And in the story, it was a leaden heart. And leaden heart was something which was totally useless otherwise. But because it had the quality to feel, so it had become precious. Got it, Jaskaran?
Now we have the
yes.
According to the happiness.
According to the?
The happiness of the poor people was the most precious thing for it.
So in the end, he says that according to the prince, happiness of the poor people was the most precious thing in the world. Yeah, that's okay. But if we are to talk about like...
According to the point of view of prince.
Yes, Jia Janvi, you want to say something? Raise hand. Yes, Jia and Janvi. Yes, you are not audible. Speak a bit louder. Or take the help of your... Yes. Yes. Okay, then the little swallow says, it's curious, but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold. Have you ever had such feeling? So did you ever have a feeling when it was actually very cold, but you felt warm? Lavanya will answer. Yes. So did you ever have this kind of feeling? Explain that. Yes, children, it's an answer. You people are to answer on your own. So think about some incident when you helped somebody and you were able to feel very satisfied. Okay? So when you say like it was very cold and you were able to feel warm, it means that you were satisfied. It's not that you didn't have the need to put on your woolens. Okay? The meaning is that you felt very satisfied. You were contented. You didn't want anything else. Okay, you didn't want anything else. And that feeling comes with sharing, with caring. So write an experience on your own. Okay, you can ask your parents anything about it if you didn't have any such experience that you write. Okay. So the suggested reading with this chapters are The Selfish Giant by Oscar Wilde. Read that story. Or How Much Land Does a Man Require by Leo Tolstoy. So when you would read these stories, you will see like they almost have the same theme which this story has. Okay?